Everyone, Jason Shepherd here, M08.com. Here's something we don't do often.
Turn left.
Right traffic. I'm going to make right traffic. I assume I'm going to call tower here. Get right traffic for 1-8. I'm out to the southwest. I assume that's going to be the case. Let's go ahead and give them a call real quick.
On short final, runway 1-8, you're cleared for the option, wind 1-6-0-8.
Clear for this. I'm looking for traffic. I want to have to with you.
Afternoon, Ocala Tower, Skyhawk 2-3, Mike Zulu.
2-3, Mike Zulu, Ocala Tower.
5 miles southwest, India, full stop.
Skyhawk 2-3, Mike Zulu, report 3 southwest for the right downwind, runway 1-8.
Call you 3 miles for a right downwind, 1-8, 2-3, Mike Zulu. 3 miles for the right downwind for 1-8. Right traffic isn't something we do all that much. Real quick, let me knock out my before landing checklist here, get everything set as far as that goes. Everything's cleaned up, lights on, and with myself, for land checklist complete in this case, bringing this airplane on down. So what I like to teach with right traffic, we want to make sure the space is right. A tendency with right traffic is to get a little bit too close to the runway. I'll explain why here. We're getting up there in just a second here. Maybe just barely start to see the Ocala Airport there. I'm still making a 45 to right down in this case. I'm still flying that. This is why it's so important to kind of know the right distance you want to be on the downwind, whether left traffic, right traffic, to be able to eyeball that in this case. Let me give him a call real quick here. And Ocala Tower, 2-3 Mike Zulu's 3 miles.
2-3 Mike Zulu, roger, and continue report midfield. There is a Cirrus, he's pretty much over the departure into 1-8. He's climbing the 2000, be turning the 230 heading.
Understand, have the traffic in sight, call you midfield, 2-3 Mike Zulu.
2-3 Mike Zulu, okay. Disregard the midfield call, I've got you in sight. You're number two following a Cessna on the right base turning final.
Number two, and I have that traffic in sight as well, 2-3 Mike Zulu.
Just 3 Mike Zulu, number two, runway 1-8, clear to land. The wind is 1-6-0-6.
Number two, clear to land, 1-8. Thank you, 2-3 Mike Zulu. All right, I'm turning my right downwind. Now, again, the tendency is to oftentimes be a little bit too close, if anything, in this case. Now, you got to remember, I'm sitting in the right seat. You're normally sitting in the left seat. You want to, it's a lot to stretch over and kind of look that way in this case. Now, in a low-wing airplane especially, too, oftentimes you're not even seeing the runway at this point, too. So just something else to kind of ponder and think about here, finding ways to practice right traffic. I've got a little bit of wind here, as you could hear. Listen to him, I got one there, I'm number two, I'm already cleared to land 1-8. Again, you add a busy environment, you had right traffic, you had kind of gusty conditions, you can see the weather's kind of coming in here a little bit. You add all these factors in here, it makes it a difficult little landing, a difficult day for someone here.
Runway 1-8.
Midfield right down 1-8, and report 3 miles, 1 Mike Alpha.
I beam my touchdown point, also a beam that aircraft, he's about over the numbers here, carb heat. Power back slightly, 10 degrees of flaps. Got a little crab in the wind. Now judging when to turn, we turn just like we always would. That 45 degree point off, we'll go ahead and make that turn. Feels weird making right traffic sometimes, but geez, what if it was on your check ride? You got shown right traffic, asked to do right traffic, and geez, you've never done right traffic. You've done it once or twice. You're about to make some very important landings, very expensive landings. They don't work out, and you haven't done much right traffic. So perhaps finding an airport that has right traffic, approaching a towered field when they're using a different runway, you know, from that direction where you know they're going to give you right traffic. That is of a benefit to you in this case. I'm on my now right base in this case, keeping it square, keeping that same distance, flying like a normal approach. Going, I'm going
to six-year vector.
I'm going to land with just 20 degrees of flaps in this case too, since it's just a little bit windy.
Returning to the east at this time. Thank you, sir.
Watching that runway, keeping sight. Again, this is where it's tough in a low-wing aircraft, knowing when to turn, everything else. Again, the tendency was to be too close. The tendency also in right traffic was too close in the downwind. The tendency is to turn a little bit too early in this case and undershoot. I'd rather undershoot than overshoot here. So I'm kind of just babying my turn on through in this case as I'm coming in to 1-8. Babying myself on through, bringing some power back. Knowing it's a little bit gusty. Know I'm kind of turning into the wind here, dealing with that crosswind from the left, anticipating that as well as I'm coming on through. Already cleared me to land. My traffic's already down. I see him off the runway up there.
671 Mike Alpha, say your distance from the airport.
Yeah, the runway's mine here.
5 miles maneuvering for the...
Crabbing into that wind.
Roger.
Again, just one last little check, double checking everything. Wind check, please.
Wind 160 at 6.
160 at 6. Okay, it's not too bad. I'm feeling it up here, though. Take it below these trees. We'll see if it gets a little bit better here. Airspeed's looking great. I'm looking at that. I don't know if you can see that windsock, but it's not showing 160, but that is A-okay. And again, right traffic, left traffic, final all looks the same. It doesn't really matter in that case now, does it? Let's get that upwind wheel down first. Yeehaw, holding it there.
671 Mike Alpha, you'll be following.
Get that nose down as well. Don't forget to put in a little crossing correction here afterwards, too.
Looking for traffic.
Makes your tax a little bit easier. I'm going to get off this runway and get out of his way here. On to Alpha 6. A little aerodynamic brake in action. Slowing this airplane on down.
Yeah. Cessna 23 Mike Zulu, turn left Alpha 6. Going back to the T-hangar, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, taxi via Alpha and Alpha 2. Just monitor ground point 4, if you would, please.
Alpha 2, monitor point 4. Thank you, 23 Mike Zulu. All right, I got all that set up. I'm going to go ahead and clean up the airplane. Can't wait to read your comments below this video. Have you done some right traffic? That's what I'm curious to know about. Enjoy the rest of your day. And most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
I wrote the private pilot blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit privatepilotblueprint.com to get your free copy.